coming up here against Atlanta.
It's always tough to pull Toby Peterson out of the Stars lineup, and he just showed why this last shift. Good, hungry net presence in and around the goal. He draws the power play. Came on the tail end of a big hit to keep the puck in. Some deep work by this line. Peterson working his way around in front. They get, I think a lot of people have been waiting around for him to blow a gasket in some ways. And Wandell line again. They were out there early here. Their first shift, they drew a power play for the Stars. This time it goes the other way. Lettinen on a line change. Watch this. 26 in a pile. Pucks and skates. And that. Right up into the belly on Little. So a good penalty killer sits.
He's not in there much. That's his first penalty this season.
Or will he end up being like Marian Gaborik in Minnesota, and who's now in New York with the Rangers? The thing you have to remember, no matter what, the attendance continues to be here in Atlanta.
Brings it to rest. Well, it's time for the On the Border All-Star Party giveaway. Text OTB PARTY to 777-111. Enter to win a catered party for 20 people from On the Border Mexican Grill and Cantina. Why? Because you can. Standard text rates apply. Beverly and Richards, the Atlanta zone.
Richard player, but he hits more guys who aren't looking, and he clocked, and I mean clocked, Alex Auld. I think they put in that five-minute interference rule for him.
Pavlik
made a couple of good glove grabs. One of the reasons that the Thrashers' penalty killing is bumped from 29th, where they finished last year, to 5th, is that man, Randy Cunningworth, who is the right-hand man for John Anderson, and he's had a real influence on their penalty killing. I played with him with the Hartford Whalers. If there's a guy who's NHL head coaching material, it's him. Time that this Wandell line sort of has put the Thrashers on the power play. Just a little too active down in the corner. He and Antropov were in there after a puck. Here it is, bouncing puck again. Comes around, and there it is, stuck him in the chin. If the Stars can just continue to get a little ahead of them, they're going to get lots of scoring.
To the room.
They were terrific in a lot of different areas. I thought defensively they played well. They got a good period out of Alex Auld, although he wasn't all that busy. And then up front, groups and packs over and over again.
Okay, folks, grab your cell phones and text Ralph, R-A-L-P-H, to 78309 to receive the latest Stars news and updates straight to your cell phone. You'll be automatically entered in a drawing to win a pair of glass seats to this Saturday's game against the Detroit Red Wings. Text.
Stefan Rota stepped up and closed the gap on him immediately. And although he got the power play goal in that first period, that's only a second point on this road trip. He hasn't been that involved in the offense, primarily because the focus has been on shutting down top lines night after night. Tonight, he'll try to get matched up against Kovalchuk as much as possible. Stars in penalty trouble here now, and this is a top 10 power play with tons of skill and plenty of weapons.
I guess his only regret, he didn't have the Wolverine.
The word on Pavlik, we haven't seen him all that much, obviously, is rebounds and a little bit of over-aggression can be his nemesis. He was in Chicago with the Wolves in the American Hockey League the last couple of years. He's got big league ability. He showed it here tonight repeatedly.
And it's one to play in the second, 3-2 Atlanta.
That's exactly the shift that the Stars needed. That line gave it to them. Spend the entire time in the attack zone, build a little momentum, get some pucks to the net. Came close to having one just slice in off somebody. They've had the odd man chances in the game. The odd man ratio in the game is 4-1 Stars. It's just that they can't, 6-3 now Stars. They just can't cash in on the opportunities when they get them. To start this over again, face-off circle to the left of Andre Pavlik. See whether they can gain control off this one. The Richards line was mad at themselves for their performance last night. They had a long talk in the room this morning trying to get their magic back again. They've been...
It should be a good third.
It should. And it's a good thing that the Stars scored there. The Thrashers are a perfect 9-0 when they're up after two periods. That was a big goal in a lot of different ways.
Dallas, as James Neal shoot-in goes off Bogosian and out of play.
He's fashioning quite the story here tonight. In the last month, Pavlik has faced over 35 shots in six of the eight games he's played, over 40 in three of them. So he's used to being busy, and the Stars are strafing him.
With Antropov there, Turco seals it off.
Well, this is a challenge for Charlie Huddy, too. He's got to try to rotate five. He's the man who's responsible, for the most part, for rotating defensemen around. And this is a big challenge for this decor tonight. They played the last two periods with five defensemen instead of six last night. And here tonight, they lost Mark Fistrick, so they're going to have to play back-to-back games with not a lot of guys in the back end.
Schubert up.
I watched Marty Turco this morning. You know, nobody's more bummed than him after the performance in Raleigh last night. He was quiet. He was focused. He went through his rhythms. He rode the bike afterward. Not his usual gregarious self. And, you know, you never know when you're going to get back in there again. I thought in some ways he might throw him right back in there again tonight. He didn't get overworked last night.
It's coming up here.
Yeah, tripping minor that came back toward the two benches. Reasoner's going to go off. It was a good penalty killer for them. Stars are one. Well, they counterpunched late in this power play right after the chime from Brad Richards, and then he served it up. Here it comes. Nice setup by Morrow. Perfect timing to get in front just as the puck's being delivered. Goalie Pavlik basically had to guess. Richards tried to go one way and then turned back, and Slater read it perfectly. There's the defensive play. They've got the leg lock on him. Say he didn't foul him from behind. He's like, I don't know. Why isn't that a penalty shot? Then around he goes. Watch this. Right in front. Zing. And missed it. The goalie Pavlik actually stole his ice a little bit and protected the puck with the shaft of his stick. And a good effort here tonight. So they're going to need another one to win.
And
section. If you're going to rebound right in front of the net, go toward the goalie and pound it through him.
The Predators, he had 7 goals and 20 points in 73 games. He's got now like 67 points in the same number of games here.
Yeah. Funny how a change of location and a different opportunity. A lot more skilled players. There's skilled players in Nashville. There's just more of them here. And they've got a go-go mentality here, and they've showcased it. The odd man chances, odd man rushes in the third period, 3-0 Atlanta, and scoring chances are starting to even up a little.
Another icing, they can't get him off.
Stars can change, though, and it looks like they're going to the Ribeiro. Line is going to come out here. Niskanen and Skrastin's on the back end. So a quick change late in the hockey game. Come with a different set on the other side. Same idea. Can you gain control and run an offensive set off this?
Ribeiro and Beverly this time to Pavlik's left. Rubin and Pavlik, who's been brilliant, allowing 5 tonight.
He really has. You know, how do you blame him for that?
You
the
know.
Last one that went in and tied it. And he is the reason why they're going to get a point at least here tonight, because the Stars, even though they have 5, could have 10.
Face off to his left, Ribeiro and Peverly. Ribeiro to Morrow.
5-0, there he fakes a shot, one move only. Pavlik bites, holds at elevation. Look at the water. Pretty simple here. Quick little shot, Marty. Well out, right between the wickets. Tied up at 1. So in the bottom of the second, Patrick Sharp will be next up for Quenneville. Sharpie anticipating Pavlik to drop down, but he was on the way to poke check, but not able to get that puck. There was room there, but a good stop by Pavlik. Rich Peverly will be the third shooter for Atlanta. Peverly, who scored a 5 in the backhand. Pavlik. The puck rolled on Patrick Kane as he made the move. Pavlik was very deep in his net. More times than not, if the goalie's out, you're going to deke. If he's very deep in his net, you're going to
chance. And Pavlik able to shut the door.
There was some room there between the legs. Not sure if you're trying to go five hole or not.
And the big boy starts the fifth inning for the Thrashers. So Dusty
was going to have first goal against in his first start.
Oh.
And he makes a flat paddle. Save on Peverly. Look at Bogosian with the setup. Coming in, it's knuckling. Oh, you can't. Peverly got more on it than we thought, Matty.
One heck of a save.
That is. It's desperation. So call Johnson a desperado. Is it paid off?
Peverly so far 5 career points in 4 games against the Rangers. Nearly had number 6 on that man, Chad Johnson.
Does Zach Bogosian look healthy now?
I think he does.
He's been struggling. We've never talked about the injury. We've seen the ice bag for the better part of 6 weeks. John Anderson saying we can probably talk about it a little bit now because he is finally healthy, and you can see in the last couple of games, Bogosian joining the rush, passing, shooting. A little wrinkle there. He usually shoots that puck from there, sending it across. They're checking to see if it crossed the line, I think.
Well, they're reviewing this one.
Did it cross? Did he, you know, the whole puck has to be across the line. The only way you can really tell is the overhead. That, no, it's not.
I don't think it's, yeah.
No. But the good news again, Zach Bogosian.
They got a break on the first goal, no doubt about it. But right now is one they deserve. Let's take a look again. The puck, I don't think he ever touches it at this point. It goes off the post. There you see it. It is, to me, it's pretty conclusive that it's in the white paint.
And they have ruled it a goal, Denny.
Yeah.
And it's 2-0 Panthers. Radek Dvorak gets the goal on the assist from Zednik.
Who's that? It's Arena.
But the Blues noticed that Emery backs in a lot on the shootout, so they tried to shoot last night. We'll see what they do here with Hedberg.
Yeah, and after Boy scored, I thought that this is the way Boy scored last night, high over the glove. I thought that with David Backes and T.J. Oshie.
No, it may have hit the post.
Yeah, it did. It went through Hedberg and then went off the post and stayed out. As a good move by Andy McDonald as he tried the deke going to his forehand. And you can see Hedberg stayed with it, got a piece of it with that right pad, and then was able to go on and hit the post. Right there, wow.
So the Thrashers a 1-0 lead after one shooter. Kozlov is next.
Interesting, Kozlov doesn't have a goal this year, John, and yet he's in the shootout.
Well, he has great hands.
Well, 348 career goals, 18th season in the National Hockey League.
And now the pressure really on Connor. And now the Blues in big trouble here in the shootout.
Yeah, the Blues virtually have to score the next 2. That's only if the Thrashers miss their third.
Rebound, and you can't get a rebound. And the Thrashers win it.
Yeah, you're right, John. Hedberg took the gamble to throw out that poke check, and he actually got and made the contact. You see right here, he makes contact with the puck. So as soon as that puck is made contact, it has to be on the original motion. But you can see there's the second motion. Watch this, here's the first. Now there's the second motion. That is considered the rebound. So that is no goal. And the Blues are denied.
Who's coming out first? Three guys.
How about that?
No, you don't know? Yeah, really. You ain't wrong, right? Little, all right.
Whenever you knock down Jaromír Jágr with a clean hit, and Jágr crumples to the ice and was slow to get up, you know it's going to get noticed by the Blue Shirts.